my dear students, good morning to all. Today in this session, we will be seeing the comparison between Ladakh and Kerala. See, we have learned that how diversity adds colors and spices in our life. How diversity makes our life colorful, right? We have discussed that Kerala and Ladakh are quite different in terms of geographical features. The history of both regions has seen similar cultural influences. Both regions, Ladakh and Kerala, one is topmost in India and the Kerala is to the bottom to India. So it is to be compared that they have some differences and have some same features. So we will discuss the geographical features. Okay, Ladakh is a cold desert and Kerala is a coastal state with fertile soil and spices. So what we can say that lifestyle, clothes, food, everything is depend on climate or atmosphere. See, Ladakh people used to wear woolen clothes because it is cold desert, right? If we see Kerala, the climate is moderate here. So people in Kerala use formal clothes. So from the dressing sense, we can say there is a diversity. In this way, geographical facts depict the diversity. Now we will see similar cultural influences of both these regions, Ladakh and Kerala. They are influenced by Chinese and Arab traders. See, Arab and Chinese traders use the mountain passes for trading. They are dealing with pashmina shawls and woolen clothes, carpets, everything. So first we will discuss about food. Okay, in Ladakh people eat milk and meat and milk products. So for that people rear goats and sheep. Agriculture is not possible much due to scanty rainfall. Okay, people get drinking water from melting snow that we have seen about Ladakh. And if we see Kerala, the land is fertile. Kerala grows rice in a large amount. Rice and fish are the main food of people. Now we will discuss about clothes. Okay, in Ladakh people wear woolen clothes. Sheep and goats, goat rearing is the main occupation. Ladakh people provide pashmina wool to Jammu and Kashmir traders. And if we see in the Kerala that because of hot and humid region, people wear light and formal clothes. Okay, now see, historically Ladakh is important because it helped in making Buddhism popular in Tibet. Are you getting me? So it is also called Little Tibet because of mixed culture. It had many passes which help to transport the goods to Tibet. And if we see Kerala, it has many colorful festivals are celebrated in Kerala. Onam is a most popular festival. It is also famous for spices, cloves and cardamoms, which they have made, the spices have made the place attractive. In Ladakh, Buddhist and Muslim population live here. Okay, Kesar Saga, the Tibetan epic sung by both. In Kerala due to the historical difference, Judaism, Christianity, Buddhism, Hinduism, Islam all together. Okay, so Apostle of Christ came here 2000 years ago and spread Christianity in India. Now we will see how there is a unity in diversity. India's diversity had always been recognized as a source of strength. There is a strength in unity. And what is unity? We have defeated British from India, right? People from different culture, different religion and region came together and opposed them, opposed to British. India's freedom movement had n number of people involved in the different backgrounds in the freedom struggle. They together worked, they together executed plan, they together went to jail and they opposed to British. British thought that they could separate us, they could divide us, but divide us because we were different, na? But our India has proved and showed them that how we were and are united, even though we look different, right? Even though we are from different religion, different region. See, the song has given in your textbook, "Don't Forget the Days of Blood, O Friend." So this song was sung after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre in Amritsar. This incident we have studied in 5th standard also. Do you remember that people gathered there to oppose British? People were from different backgrounds. Poor, rich, Hindu, Sikh, Muslims. And how British killed them. So this song was composed and sung to honor the memory of those brave people. Our songs and symbols during the freedom struggle always boosted us. Our Indian flag, our Tiranga, was used as a symbol of protest against the British. And like it was telling that yes, we are united though we are different. If we see our national flag, Punjab, Sindh, Gujarat, Maratha, Dravid, Utkala, Banga, means people from different regions, people from Punjab, people from Gujarat, people from Maharashtra, people from South India, Orissa, Bengal, okay? So they are, the people are expressing gratitude towards our country through this national anthem, which is written, which is composed by Rabindranath Tagore, right? Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru says in his book of Discovery of India that Indian unity is not something imposed from the outside, but it was deeper, widest tolerance of belief and customs was practiced. Pandit Nehru was the first prime minister. He wrote the book Discovery of India. And what he says in his book, that unity is there in people's mind. It is inculcated in them. Okay. And Pandit Nehru coined the phrase that unity in diversity. So my friends, see the journey of our chapter, the from the story Samir 1 and Samir 2. Then we learn that what does diversity add to our lives? Then diversity in India, the types of diversities, how geographical factors influence the diversity. That everything we have studied through Ladakh and Kerala. And at the last we have studied how there is a unity in diversity. Okay. So hope you have understood this chapter, Understanding Diversity. See you next time with the new chapter. Till that, stay home, stay safe. Bye.